The bill aims to repeal the similar law introduced in 1938, as well as the Casino and Gambling House Act of 1994. The main objective is to regulate gambling and gambling activities in the country and set out principles for such activities. It further aims to protect gamblers, ensure revenue generation, establishment of the Gambling Board and the Gambling Trust Fund, and also provides for incidental matters, among others.
This piece of legislation will not only ensure strict regulation of the gambling activities, but it has new provisions to protect members of the public who participate in these activities, the society and the national economy at large. We are also trying to ensure that the issuing of licenses in respect of gambling and gambling activities is transparent, fair and equitable.
There are currently 260 gambling license holders. 6 were issued for casinos and 254 for gambling houses. The 6 casinos have 1,145 registered gambling machines, while 1,700 belongs to gambling houses. These figures represent a combined contribution of about $22 million annually to state revenue. Parliamentarians had their inputs into the bill.
We know people that play dice in the street. What happens? Does this law regulate that? And those also play on the winning principle, the cards on Longomagadi. If they are playing to win, how is this being regulated?
And I believe that a prize money from gaming, is for sure equivalent to other prize monies that are earned by whoever, and that they should be subject to tax.
Don't we start with something without that board, maybe managed by the permanent secretary of a ministry and other people who are there, designed, and they are not paid remuneration because they are already paid? Why don't we start with this? Every time boards, and then they fail us. And this process may not also meet our expectations.
There is about 2,600 illegal gambling houses with about 20,000 machines. The ministry therefore plans to put an end to these illegal activities and ensure that there is a maximum allocation per region. This will promote economic empowerment for the previously disadvantaged and also ensure new entrants into the industry while further creating jobs. Debate on the bill continues. Jephthah Shihumino, NBC News, Windhoek.